Good morning, class. Myself, Dr. Ashwini Kardole. I am assistant professor in community medicine department, REMS Raipur. Before discussing today's topic, you all are exam going students, and in I think July or August you will give your theory and practical exam for community medicine. So before that, we will discuss some point related to examination, how to write down examination, and what usually all people expect in theory and practicals also. So we will discuss that. As community medicine is very volatile subject, there is no option, you have to read it, and this is your revision class, so it is not possible to take your whole complete class like other days classes. So we will try to cover some important points in your class, in this revision class, and whatever you have doubt, you can ask me regarding that. But you people mentioned concept of health, epidemiology, maternal and child health, and communicable diseases. So we will try to cover maternal child health in this revision class. With epidemiology also we will try to cover some part of concept of health, we will try to discuss that. But it is not possible to discuss everything about communicable disease. So if time is there after all these classes, then we will try to take all communicable diseases also, communicable and non-communicable diseases in these classes. So in theory, in previous examination we have seen that you have to write down something in your paper. It is not like that you will leave that question completely and you will get marks. You have to read at least question related something in that. You have for that, if SAQ is there, try to write in 3 or 4 pages or short answer question, and long answer question is if it is there, then try to write at least 6 to 7 pages or 5 to 6 pages depending upon the questions. So whatever question is there, try to elaborate this thing. If you have a program related question, then try to write down something about program. If you are writing some reading some program, then mug up it like goals and objective of program, then strategies of that program, core components of that program, and whatever strength, weakness of that program. On the basis of that, you can mug up all that program. But goals and objectives of your program, that should be specific. It is not like that in TB, if it is 85% reduction in cases, then you will write 35%, that the marks will automatically deducted if you write down something else in that. Definitions and principles kind of thing you have to mug up. There is no other option. And if you know something about this subject, is like ki general topics are also there, medicine, gynae and pediatrics, some points, some topics are also there. So you can collect all the whatever information you have, you can write down in on the basis of that. And whatever treatment you are going to write in that, whatever strategy of any program or anything you know, you can write down in primary, secondary and tertiary prevention kind of thing. Primary, secondary and tertiary kind of thing, in that whatever question you have asked in the paper. So in primary, primary thing, primordial prevention and primary prevention you can write down. In secondary and tertiary prevention, elaborate that things in that form, so that every point will cover in that. And etiological factor, triad, epidemiological triad, whatever thing, whatever communicable disease, non-communicable disease, if come, you have to complete in epidemiological triad, then pathogenesis, then treatment in primary, secondary and tertiary prevention guideline in that. So that is about a theory question. Now for the practical thing, spotting is very easy if means we will try to do it that spotting or revision of spotting also. But statistics, last time we kept very easy form of question in statistics, like mean, median, mode, standard deviation, odds ratio kind of thing. So you can revise all these forms, so that will be easy for you. Some diagrams, epidemiological curve, epidemic means calculation of crude birth rate, death rate, indicators, you can mug up all that formulas and easily you can solve that statistical problems. Then spotting is also that usual whatever spots you have seen in all your previous years, that only we will kept in your exam. And other than this, cases in previous batch we have given 10 cases to all the students. Out of that they will select turn by turn that cases and they have to present that only cases. This time what format they will conduct, means external or internal will conduct, that is depend on them, but we will try to find out something good for you. Okay, then this is all about your theory as well as practical class. But theory you have to write down in your theory paper, that is related to, that should be related to topic. It is not like that you will randomly write down something else and you will get point out of it. It will be not like that, because all your theory papers will be checked by external and internal also. So there is no scope for anything. So you have to be very cautious about your theory as well as practicals. Okay, then in some classes today we will start a maternal and childhood services or chapter, and after that in some classes we will try to cover up all this MCH chapter. But it will be not like that I will cover each and everything from that, but important point or just glance of MCH I'll take that, and after that you have to read that. Okay, then today we will start delivering the MCH services. Whatever services are there, MCH related, maternal and child health related services, like Janani Suraksha Yojana, Janani Shishu Suraksha Karyakram, MCH, maternal and child health services, then RMNCH A+, then reproductive child health and adolescent health services are there, whatever immunization services, all those services are related to MCH services, and all the services are target based. In this you can get questions like that, what are the targets of MCH services, like that. This is your long question also, so you can see that. And one more thing, you have to check previous 5 or 10 years paper, so that you will get to know what are the important topics from the community medicine. Okay, so this is your LAQ type of question, in that what are the targets of maternal and child health services, that you have to elaborate in further slides. So in which whatever indicators are there in the community is present, that is all taken as a target, and on the basis of all that target they have conducted some programs by government in the community to betterment of community prevalence of other diseases in the community, in which infant mortality rate and maternal mortality rate, this indicator is very important. Whatever health services system related to maternal child health, it is depend on infant mortality rate and maternal mortality rate. If any country is having infant mortality rate and maternal mortality rate is very high, that means their healthcare services are not proper, not at a optimum level. So on the basis of all this indicator, they have set some targets. in coming years, in 5 years plan or in any program, in that they have taken crude birth rate, total fertility rate, infant mortality rate, maternal mortality rate, low birth weight, vaccination coverage, how much vaccination coverage in a country or in a specific area, pregnancy and TT injections during pregnancy, how much percentage they have given, and ANC utilization of ANC services, institutional deliveries, how much institutional delivery have conduct in this program, and delivery by trained person. All these are they have done some survey in different region of the different community, and certain targets are come some prevalence of diseases come out after that, and after that they have decided ki if 30% and 60% infant mortality rate is there, then we have to reduce it by 50%, then in next 5 year we will come down by 30 in 1000 live birth we will come down that 50% prevalence of infant mortality. Likewise, they set all the target in MCS services. So if you get a question for MCS services or target base, then you have to write down some introduction point of related to MCS services, then what are the targets related to that, and what are the facilities are available in that, and how government is dealing with that services. Now delivering the MCH services should be in promotive, curative and preventive measures. That all aspect we have to cover, like curative, preventive and promotive strategies should be present in that. And method of delivering of healthcare to special group, mostly in under 5 children and reproductive age group women. They target mostly under 5 women, under 5 children and reproductive age group women, that is 15 to 45 years or 44 years. It should be 45 years reproductive age group. So they will take data of all under 5 student, under 5 children and reproductive age group women, and whatever population is there, they will do screening of that, and what is prevalent diseases in that, and what type of misconception, what type of myths, what type of taboos, what type of delivery system in their area, how health seeking behavior is present or not. Whatever lacunes in that area, they will collect all the data on the basis of, they will deliver all the MCH related services in that area. Then specific objectives of maternal and child health is, number one objective is reduction of morbidity and mortality rate of mother and children. Whatever morbidity and mortality are common in mother and child, we have to reduce that. In children, mostly pneumonia, measles, fever, then diarrhea, all that kind of diseases are very common in India in less than 1 year children and less than 5 year children. Likewise, in mothers, PPH, postpartum hemorrhage, anemia, worm infestation, lack of education and awareness about pregnancy, home deliveries, or lack of knowledge of their healthcare services in that area. All these are very common problems. So we have to reduce, empower them by education and providing the appropriate technology or appropriate health system in that area to reduce the mortality and morbidity for women and children. Promotion of reproductive health. For whatever awareness program is going on, it is on the basis of previous survey, and they are going to promote the reproductive health. How should be the reproductive health for adolescent girl, so that healthy pregnancy in a reproductive age group will be conducted by the all the women. So all this promotion of healthy lifestyle of reproductive health, they will there is one object objective. Then promotion of physical and psychological development of child within the family. This is one of the objective. For that, Urge Clinic is also there in primary health center or community health center. So that whatever adolescent male or female, boy and girl, they give education related to reproductive health, sex education also, STDs also, how to prevent pregnancies and how they can regulate the menstruation also, and menstruation related problem also they discuss in the Arsh clinic. So promotion of physical psychological development of child within the family also and in the community also, that is also one of the objective for the in the family. Health education of parent and children. Health is an issue, it is not related to one individual, it is a complete complete education should give to parent as well as children. At the community level, that Asha or Anganwadi worker used to give health education to all the parents. They used to gather all the parents or reproductive age group women or men from the community, and they give health education to the parents also and children also. Ultimate objective of MCS services is lifelong health. It is health is not for a short term also. Throughout life, that person should be healthy. So ultimate objective of MCH services is, that is long term goal is health for long life, for healthy and long life for the person. This is the all objectives for MCH services. Now, sub areas of maternal and child health in which they work is maternal health, family planning, child health, school health, handicapped children, and care care of child in special setting like daycare center or in other in schools also they are giving some special program like midday milk, in that they give health education to the children also. So in all this area they are working, like maternal health, family matter. In maternal health they are giving antenatal, prenatal and postnatal advice also, high risk pregnancy detection, pregnancy tracking of the pregnant mother, and after delivery she is taking or not taking all the healthcare services which are provided by the government, that is also Asha and Anganwadi worker follow all the procedures. And in family planning, all the contraceptive related, they give cafeteria approach to all the female or male, that is for the couple, so that whatever choice is for them is suitable, so they can pick up that family planning method, they can use that family planning method. Child health, and for under 5 child health, they have started Anganwadi services also, immunization services also, and the supplementation of food in Anganwadi centers, and slight means health education to children, so that that whatever good habits are developed in childhood, they can continue after that for lifelong. So, and in MCS services they also include school health, so in that every 6 monthly every child of government school and some private school, they include in that they include all the students, they give regular health checkup to all the students from head to all the health checkup they have used to do in that. Refractive errors are if there, worm infestation is there, dental caries, skin related problem is there, vitamin deficiency, they refer all this patient to the all the students, whatever whoever is having health problem, they refer to primary health center, and after that they follow up, they do follow up for that student also. handicap for handicapped student, there is a special provision. They provide some special healthcare and special program for handicapped people also. After that, Chirayu is one program in that they give some services in for handicapped children also. Then care for child in special setting like daycare setting, likewise Anganwadi center is also there. MCH services is vary according to demographic, social and economical pattern. It is not like that in hilly area same kind of MCH services will be present as normal areas. It differs from place to place, from surface to surface and from population wise also. Services should be flexible and based on adapted to local needs and resource of the community. If we are giving MCS services, what basic MCS services in affluent society, that is of no use. So that services should be flexible and it should be give to the appropriate, your target population should be appropriate, and whatever services you are giving that should be need based, and whatever resources are present in that community you have to use that resource, like community participation you can do, like our best example is ASHA. There should be use of local traditional culture, health care and social legislation and social support measure. We have to, it's not MCS services is not like that you are giving care to people and they'll take that. You have to include their traditional cultural practice also in your healthcare services. You have to give respect to their cultural and traditional practice, so that automatically if you are giving respect to their cultural traditional practice, whatever are good practice, those are good practice, if you are giving respect to them, automatically they'll take care of you also and they will start using your healthcare service also. So it is a two-way situation, it should be in two-way direction. It's not we are not going to rule anyone, we have to support all the community people. So you have to take it in you have to support all the majors, social majors are there, after that they'll start believing in you. MCH, all activities which promote health and prevent or solve health problem of mother and child. There is routine activity, they means every 9th, all the different, at the different setting, the maternal child health services are different. Some universal programs are there, but whatever problems in some areas, goiter is very endemic, so for pregnant pregnancy and for adolescent girl, we have to first assess that goiter problem. You have to measure TSH level first, and you have to start hypertensive drugs, whatever hypothyroidism related problem is there, we have to solve that problem. If somewhere anemia is prevalent, we have to solve that problem. It should be like a problem based MCS services should give in a area, so that a whole problem can solve in that community. Recent trend in MCH care nowadays means in the last decade, after measuring all the indicators, there is addition of some special trends in healthcare services, like in MCH services, in which integration of care, it is an risk approach, they have added manpower changes and primary healthcare services, they have added. One by one we will see that. In integration of care, in whatever ANC, PNC or infant care or family planning, they integrated everything in that. Health for woman and child, it is not a single thing. It should be integration of everything, from the childhood to reproductive age group or up to the geriatric age. You have to integrate everything in that program so that you can give take care to that you can take care to that. So they include all the program related to ANC, PNC, infant care and family planning, means contraceptive related. There should be integrated approach. There should be in maternal child health, whatever local facilities are, there is always crunch of manpower in India like country. So whatever resources are available in your setting, you have to take all that, you have to use all that area. Whatever local dai is present, you can teach her, you can give certificate to her that she can conduct deliveries. For that she has to do some training for a certain months, and we can use that local dai for the delivery system. So whatever manpower is available in that community, like Asha, we choose from the community itself. So we can use that is community participation in the MCS services is very important to promote all the healthcare services and give effective MCH program. Risk approach is new promising means of improving the coverage and efficiency of MCH care. This is the very better tool for all the resources. It is based on early detection of mother and children with the high risk factor. All mother and children with high risk factor are giving additional or more skilled are included in hospitalization, while at the same time essential care is provided for all the rest of the mother and children so that everyone get care appropriate to their need. Risk approach they have started on the basis of this. That and very important thing is to assess the degree of risk of each factor by scoring according to their magnitude of problem. Whatever magnitude of problem is, we have to assess that, and likewise we have to give healthcare services to that. Whatever treatment and whatever services you are giving under MCH services, that should be cost effective. It is not like that you are giving a delivery health system and hospital, you are promoting hospital delivery and cost of that hospital is very high, so nobody is going for delivery in that hospital. So whatever cost, that should be minimum, that service should be effective in that area. And community attitude and social concern should be taken care in that area, so that whatever problem is present, that should be sorted out. Manpower changes. Third is manpower changes. A wide range of workers are now considered necessary for MCH care. ASHA workers are tremendous, giving positive effect in this area. So we are recruiting more and more ASHA workers so that at the grassroots level we can deal with all these MCH related problem, and we will give close inspection of all the MCH problem. So specialist professional specialists we will appoint in certain areas. Field worker like multi-purpose worker, health guide, dais, traditional birth attendees, Anganwadi worker, all these are field worker we will appoint for the. And voluntary worker, if anybody want to help in that organization or in program, they can also participate in that program. So initially only a healthcare system was there. In last decade, ASHA worker and professional worker and multi-purpose worker, they have started working in this area, and after that so much changes are there, so many changes are there, and positive effect of maternal child health we have seen. This is also we discuss. So after that, fourth one is primary health care. primary healthcare is now recognized as way of making essential healthcare available to all. It is not like that ki tertiary level care like AIIMS like hospital will be everywhere. So we have to give first basic thing to community person so that primary healthcare system started, PHC started everywhere under subcenter has also started. Subcenter is under the primary healthcare center, and whatever complicated cases come to the primary health care that is not manageable in that area, they refer to the community health center or tertiary level health care center. It has all element necessary to make positive impact on the health of mother and children, that is MCH care and family planning, control of infections, education about health problem, how to prevent them, that all emphasize in primary health care system. That they are giving family orientation care and support to all the community in which they are giving services. MCH care is an indispensable priority element for the primary health care in every country. Organization for primary health care and family planning services are, it should be integrated. It is better effectiveness should be there. It is that effectiveness of any program that should be measurable, so that indicators are very important to measure all the effectiveness of the program. Integral part of primary health care should be core term. Whatever basic treatment are given, they are giving in the primary health care, that should be full fledged with all equipments. All basic equipment and basic treatment should they give should they give in the primary health care, and emphasis should be on community participation. Best example is ASHA and intersectoral coordination, that private and government coordination is very important for healthcare system, for any type of healthcare system. In rural areas, primary health care and their sub-centers are present, in which mostly 30,000 to 40,000 population in rural areas, it is given to the primary health center. And for sub-center, 3,000 to 5,000 population is they have given. It is different, it is differ area-wise or hilly region-wise also. It is not like this much population should require, minimum or maximum population should be there for the PHC and subcenter. Each subcenter, one health worker male and health worker female should be there. Local train dies to conduct safe deliveries in the rural area, or any trained person should be there. Village health guide should involve MCH services and family planning activities also. ICDS services should be there, and Anganwadi workers are present in Anganwadi. Those should be included in the MCH services. All these programs are sponsored by central government and state government. MCH immunization for pregnant mother, for children, prophylaxis again, nutritional anemia for mothers and for children and for adolescent girls also, prophylaxis again, blindness in children 1 to 5 years due to vitamin A deficiency. That all this program, vitamin A deficiency program, anemia Mukt Bharat program, universal immunization program, MCH services, RMNCH services, all our programs comes under central government as well as state government. Now in urban areas, most of the deliveries takes place in maternity hospital or maternity home. It is a data, but some parts like urban slums are also there in which home deliveries are very prevalent. So it is not like that ki urban areas most of the delivery. Nowadays they have started institutional deliveries, but previously in urban areas also home deliveries was very prevalent. obstetrician are available at district hospital and pediatric unit should be present in the urban areas so that NICU, NICU/PICU should be present in the health care facilities. All hospital, all maternity hospital, primary healthcare delivery system hospital should be baby friendly hospital, that is breastfeeding promotion of breastfeeding should be there as early as possible. After delivery, baby should start breastfeeding. Baby friendly this initiative, baby friendly hospital, have started by WHO and UNICEF to reduce the infant mortality rate and under 5 mortality rate. Mother's milk is boon for the all the children, for the children. So breast milk is, and so many taboos are related to that. Means first 3 days milk is waste milk, that colostrum is not useful for baby. So many beliefs were there. So to tackle all this belief and give a positive effect to the baby, they have started baby friendly hospital, in that they promote the breastfeeding. If baby is IUGR or low birth weight baby, kangaroo mother care, they have started in the all the hospital. Encouraging the proper infant feeding practice and starting at the birth, after normal birth also, after C-section also, they encourage the proper infant feeding. Helping the mother to initiate breastfeeding, 4 hour follow cesarean section, encouraging the breastfeeding on the demand. It is not necessary you have to start after 4 hour after C-section. Whenever mother is feeling good after that C-section or delivery, she can give breast milk. And there is no food, no drink other than breast milk. That is exclusive breast feeding should be should give to the babies for minimum 6 months. After that, supplementation of other food they can start. All this they promote in baby friendly hospital, and all maternity home and all hospitals should follow all this practice. Their mother and child should be taken as one unit during pregnancy. Fetus is a part of mother, that is complete duration is 280 days, and it's not like that you will deal with fetus only, you will deal with mother only. It is a complete unit. If something is happened to mother, automatically a side effect will give to the baby. So you have to tackle whatever problem is present with baby and mother, you have to deal with that. And whatever diseases are present during pregnancy or previously, like anemia, if present during adolescent period and pre-pregnancy period, it is automatically give bad effect to the babies. So you have to deal all the diseases of adolescent, diseases of women during adolescency and during pregnancy also, and after that also, postpartum also. So we have to take care for mother and child health, and we have to consider it as a one unit. Whatever problems are there, MCH related problem, all this we will discuss in MCH related problem in further classes in a brief, but shortly. Perinatal problem, congenital malformation, genetic and certain behavior problem are there. Spacing of pregnancy, that is lack of use of contraceptives by the couples, that is also one of the problem in India or in some countries. Limitations of family size, prevention of communicable diseases, improvement of nutrition and promoting the acceptance. All these are problem related to maternal and child health. We will discuss it thoroughly in next class. So that is just touch to the healthcare services and delivery system of maternal and child health, in which MCH services, RCH reproductive and child health, maternal child health program is there, RMNCH plus program is there, ARSH program is there,
जननी शिशु सुरक्षा कार्यक्रम एंड ऑल दैट प्रोग्राम यू हैव टू रीड देयर टारगेट गोल्स ऑब्जेक्टिव्स देयर स्ट्रैटेजीज यू हैव टू मग अप यू हैव टू राइट डाउन ऑन पॉइंट वाइज बेसिस सो दैट इट विल ऑटोमेटिकली कवर नो बडी इज गोइंग टू रीड योर होल पेपर इफ पॉइंट्स आर प्रेजेंट दैट विल बी ईजी टू चेक योर पेपर सो ट्राई टू राइट डाउन इन अ पॉइंट एंड सम लाइन्स टू डिस्क्राइब दैट पॉइंट सो दैट दैट लेंथ ऑफ यूर एस ए क्यू एंड एल ए क्यू विल बी मोर एंड इट विल गिव स्ट्रेंथ टू फॉर टू योर थियरी पेपर सो इन नेक्स्ट क्लास वी विल डिस्कस मोर अबाउट एम सी एच maternal and child health. Thank you.